So how's your experience been on this 2014 draft?
Well, you know, it's just been a really good experience. It's cool to be here with all these players you played against, played with, and to finally be here on the big stage is a great feeling.
The last one.
I'm a grandma mom when it comes to getting off the bus.
To be in Mohegan and just the kind of environment, I think we're all starting to feel a little bit.
It hasn't really hit me yet. Maybe a little later when we get on the set, but right now I'm still kind of just.
Thank you. This is our pregame huddle. What are you guys thinking like about right now? It's more.
It's crazy.
I think I've put in my 2 cents for the past like 22 years. So.
Right now I'm just excited and anxious to see what's gonna happen, and I couldn't be more happy to be here.
Good. I'm excited. They're making me nervous.
Good evening, and welcome to the 2014 WNBA Draft.
All right, the pick is in. Let's go to the podium. Laurel Richie, the president of the WNBA, standing by.
With the first pick in the 2014 WNBA Draft, the Connecticut Sun select Chinne Agumike from Stanford.
Well, how did it feel when you heard your name called?
Honestly, I don't know what I was feeling because I was in this state of euphoria. A dream came true, and I'm just so excited.
So, Tulsa,
take over.
We are taking guard Odyssey Sims from Baylor.
Didn't expect to go so high. It's a dream come true. Very, very, very happy.
You gotta keep it.
With the third pick, the San Antonio Stars select Kayla McBride from University of Notre Dame.
We made it. I was just like, my heart was beating so bad. I was getting
almost called my parents.
I'm like sitting there like.
It's definitely nerve-wracking in there when you don't know what's gonna happen, but you know, once they call your name, you know exactly where you're going, and it's a little bit of a sense of relief, but at the same time, you know, it is that next chapter and you just gotta keep getting better and working harder.
WNBA Draft Day, we out.